Okay, here we are, Wednesday night, it's nice and late. It's May 4th, only me and Rabbi Nassim over here. We started doing some halachot of Sefirat HaOmer from the book Usfartim Nachem of Rabbi Dekel, Cohen. We just mentioned that you can most definitely, based upon almost all the Rishonim, and of course some Aharonim, say the berakha of Sefirat HaOmer and count the day of Sefirat HaOmer immediately upon sunset, any time thereafter within Be'er Shem HaShot. You do not have to wait for Seder Kochavim. And now we are going to continue the Halachot. And just one quick note, Maran says, Medaktikim. Okay, well, his exact words from Maran. Medaktikim enam sofrim al Seder Kochavim. The Medaktikim don't count until Seder Kochavim, and this is, you know, it's worthy to do as such. But that is not the halakha. You do not have to do as such. And therefore, especially B'Sibur, you know, you have the entire congregation there, and it's already sunset, and they're going to leave, and you have, especially if a chance people are going to forget, all the more so would make more sense to count. Okay.
Okay, great.
He's telling us this is the minhag of the ulam to wait. Okay, and he's basically quoting Maran in the Beit Yosef, basically based upon the Rashba. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And look, it's very funny because he doesn't say, V'chein masak derbi yospa, shemish b'minhagim, of Vermiza. So he's quoting Ashkenazim who said this is their custom.
To wait.
This is basically the custom that we see nowadays. This is obviously, you know, in the world that we live in, things have gotten a little more unified in the
stricter sense.
In the stricter sense, right. V'ra'uy v'nachon, shebemkomo shemetpallelin tefillat mincha mukdam. ידרוש תמיד החכם לקהל דברי תורה ומוסר עד שיגיע הזמן כדי שיוכלו לספור העומר מסדר כוכבים. And obviously he told you it's very, very correct that, you know, in places that they pray mincha early, that the תמיד החכם, who is among them, should speak to the קהל דברי תורה ומוסר until the correct time comes, and therefore everybody will be able to count the עומר at סדר כוכבים. אבל סיבור שמסיימים תפילה לערבית בבין השם השואו יספרו מיד אחר תפילתם. But a סיבור, a minyan, a group of people that is praying and they conclude ערבית during בין השם השואו, that means any time after sunset and it is not yet סתר כוכבים, they should count immediately. And that means with a ברכה, count immediately after they finish praying. And if they want to be stringent like the Medaktikim, they should still count that point but without a berakha. They should make a condition beforehand, if they remember to go and count again after Seder Kochavim, after the stars come out, there is no credence whatsoever to the counting that they're doing now during Ben Hashem HaShot, the counting that they're doing without a berakha, v'resha'im b'sedek kohavim l'chazov l'spor berakha, and they can, after sedek kohavim, they can go and count again with a berakha. And this is based upon the Turezahab and the, what do you call it, and the Gaon Mevilna and his Shulchan Aruch, and also called the Aruch HaShulchan.
What's the Gaon Mevilna or the Gaon Rabbeinu Zalman? Who's
that's not him?
No.
No, Rabbeinu Zalman is who? Wait.
The Lubavitch Rabbi.
The Lubavitch?
Right.
I'm sorry, you're correct. Okay.
Right.
You're right.
And who's the last one?
Aruch HaShulchan.
Aruch HaShulchan, okay.
Okay.
I know. So the Aruch HaShulchan brings this down. This sounds like a very strange Tevara.
It's quoting the Torah Zahav first.
Right.
So it's not something that we just made up yesterday.
Right.
It's something that's been around for a while.
Right.
Like I told you, this is a very, very thorough book. He covers everything. You never saw a whole book that deals with... It doesn't talk about the minhagim of cutting hair or music or anything. It doesn't deal with those subjects at all. He just deals with counting the omer.
Right, with the actual law.
Yeah.
Right.
Of Sefirah.
Yeah, it's just that this sevara sounds
It's weird.
It's a weird sevara.
It's only weird to us because we're not in the inyan. If we're into it and we read it, you know, we'll see what's going on. May not be that strange. Oh, let's see. Let's continue and see what he has to say now. Because the text is going to be interesting.
You have Aruch HaShulchan, yes?
I do not have.
Oh, you don't have it?
No, I do not. You have it in the school level, in university.
Yeah.
Take a look.
Okay.
Sibur. Shirigilim kol ha-shana al-pallei tifel arbim pelag minha. We have a minyan that throughout the year, winter, summer, whatever it may be, they pray arbit at pelag minha. Pelag minha, as we know, is much earlier than sunset. Ve'rosim lehamshich baze af b'mei ha-sefira, and they want to continue with their minyan that prays early, even during the days of the Sefirat HaOmer. Ve'lispor b'berakha mi'ed ha-har tifel, and they want to count the Omer with the berakha immediately upon their concluding of arbit, when it is still definitely daytime according to everybody. Yesh lehem al mashi smucho. They have sources upon which to rely. Even though it is not yet, even b'nei shemashot, the sun definitely did not set yet. The sun is still up, and they still have sources upon which to rely to count with the berakha. Let's see who is quoting for this. He starts with the Tosafot. And Tosafot b'berachot. Hebi Yehuda, Rabbi Notam, the Efda Anyan Kriyat Shema'a Shal Arbi Sevira Leid Rabbi Yehuda, the Impelak Menhal Zemana. Hirba Sakh Rabaya. Be'osib the Mahmir Pelet of Arbi Belel Mash Mahzik Yuhara. Shekola Osid Dabar, the Eno Sarif, Nikra Hediot. Imlo Shahurgal Beperishut. Very powerful state.
Right, assuming that. See, he's probably looking at the entire Kahal is praying at once, and I want to stay later and read the Shema.
That's right. That's exactly what he's looking at.
Mechazek Yehora, right.
Sure. V'yivyon ha'lecha ha'mordechi v'berachot, ayin sham. V'ayin o'er b'tiruvat ha'deshin. O'lefi zeh, o'adim b'sifrat ha'omen, d'shefir d'ameh, d'spo b'pelag melcha. Obviously, if you could do for Shema, you could definitely do for Sefirat HaOmer, according to what he's telling you over here. Okay. Bechikat ha mi'iri pusahim sheish omrim sheefshar lispor sefirat ha'omer kodem hashicha kol shel palel arbit. Okay. Mi'iri brings down that those who say that it's permissible, you know, to count the omer before it gets dark, before the sun goes down, as long as you pray arbit. Ayin shem. Bechin hu b'sket tosafot b'nachot. Bechin ketav b'sefer minhagut. Shekin nahagu. Bechin muchach ma shekin maran. בשולחנו הטהור, סעיף ג', שמפלל עם הסיבור, שמקדימים. He prays with a group of people that are early. יספור עמם ולא ברכה. ואם יזכור בלילה, יחזור בימי ברכה. So he should count with them without ברכה, and then if he remembers at night, he should count again with a ברכה. Okay, so this might give you some sort of footage on that previous, you know, halakha that you sound so strange. Ubekolo b'mahzur vitri, kim bu'ar bet Yosef. Kin ketab b'isu v'hetel rashi, b'sefer ha'ora v'od. Umedelo he'iru al-min ha'gam kelal, mi bu'ar t'shvir abde. And since they didn't comment upon it and say anything about their custom, obviously, that they saw no problem with this, and they saw that you can do it. ומה שכתבנו שרק אם רגילים בזה כל השנה הראשיים לעשות כן. And what we wrote over here now, I wrote someone about himself. I wrote only if they use this the entire year. היינו משום שרבנו יונה בברכות. This is because of רבנו יונה בברכות. והראש שם, כתבו. דמי דאמרינן שם. דעבד כמון עבד, דעבד כמון עבד. היינו שיעשה לעולם כחמינאיו. We say, if you do like this, fine. If you do like this, fine.
Right.
But you can't be up in the air constantly. You have to be consistent. You have to pick a path, a pattern, and you do it, and you follow it. You know, and so if this is the way you always do it, that's it.
Right.
פעמים כרבי יהודה, פעמים כרבנן. ושכח פירש הרעה. Who's הרעה? אני יודע.
I think it's Ashkenazi and he's Rishon, but I'm not sure.
הרעה בתלמודה
Right? If I don't do it at the same time.
Thank you. I couldn't read it right, and I messed it up. Right. So the Ra'a is saying what?
Right. So if the same day I'm contradicting myself. Bebat ahad. Right.
The shelo bebat ahad.
Right. The shelo bebat ahad shari.
Sorry, it would be permissible.
Right. So as long as I'm not contradicting myself.
Right.
But if once in a while I switch back and forth,
it shouldn't be a problem.
Right, they're going to allow me.
اختبري هاشتماء كين كتاب مردخي شام بسمان بيتيت لبشات الدحاق عبدينان هاخيد تحلا ما ينشام اختبري هراء كين كتاب ميري شام ميكوما كو مع حاشر وريشون يسورين شي اين سبور ببلاك الملحا كين بوا بها عراها باء but since most of the shonim said you should not count بلاك الملحا like we're going to write in the next note لخين دينو لكل كشريجين عزوكين كل سنة. So it's enough for us to say that it, you know, we could be lenient for those who are accustomed to such a praying, you know, situation throughout the year. The Bazimbu are that it's, you know, over there it's explained understandable. Madu Amara Katab Rakli Yahid she is poor imam below berakha bela berakha. Going to say Maran said for the Yahid to count with them without berakha. For the Sibur, he didn't say anything. For the Sibur, no problem, because they're used to doing it. But for this Yahid, who's not usually part of that Sibur, then he has, you know, count with them with a, you know, so you should not be Purish from the Sibur, and then count later with the Berakha. But the Yahid, he doesn't say anything. Very nice. He fixed it up on the bottom.
Right, it's the hook, I think. It's a tough one.
It's a tough one, what? For the Sibur or to say that it's only for the Sibur that's used to it throughout the year?
Right, right. Maran is allowing it for the Sibur. Maran is difficult, I should say. You know, now he really made me think about this. Maran is really difficult.
Mm-hmm. No, because this Yahid is not part of that group. For him, for that Yahid, this is like, it's also strange. This group of people, this is their regular thing. You're the oddball now. You're the outside guy who came in. You know, so you...
So
you do what you usually do.
That's why I remember... You want to look at Maran? I remember Maran. It sounds like... Yeah, I don't remember.
هم بلي ما سبون بعجوم مريع مهين بلو برخاه بمسكو بلالي بريخ بيسبون مقولوه تأهور بأبو درهم بشين محصور فيتريك من بغربة يوسف.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes,
and that's the same. He actually said, "Boo, so from his banze." Hello, Adain, who gives the man a sefira.
Right.
Ukmi Boar, the Sayif Shakodemze, the Sayif Shaharze, Shah Sofer, Kodem Ben Shemashot, Lo Azakilum, the Sayif Lashuv, the Sport Ben Shemashot.
Beauty. Okay.
The Otkashe Mian is a fellow so it at Yashapir. And my loss of it in my hand, Bibraka.
Right.
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 Right. Right. That's the way they're all explaining it. Safek Hashikha. Ve'osiv ha'turizab sham. Ve'mash sarikh l'spor imam. Haynu kedeh she'lo yihashiduhu. Ve'un osed l'spor b'sadeh kochavim. Ve'lachin eno sofer imam b'bracha. Now, she'lo yihashiduhu. For what? We told them maybe they think it's a karai?
I guess that
Siddhuki?
Is Yehuda probably.
Maybe Yehuda. But yahshiduhu, it's a strong word to write. It wouldn't, usually we say, kimahzika yuhara, you know?
Right.
Interesting term. Verse of the spoor b'sidak havim. V'lachin eno sofer imam b'racha, v'rak b'sidak havim yispoor b'racha. This seems to make sense, according to what you're saying. V'hu ba b'shmei hagigah sham. V'hineh, ma'ashikad bu'aharonim. לעניות דעתי דוחק גדול הוא לפרש כן שאלה בכל מקום בעוד יום היינו בעוד היום גדול. And he's right. It's true. We never see, you know, בעוד יום meaning בין השמשות. וכשעשה מרן לומר בין השמשות כתב כן בפירוש כדי לקמם בסעיף דלת. ואף דהתם אפשר לומר שכתב כן כדי לחלק בפירוש בין השמשות לקודם לכן כמו שהמשיך שם אבל קודם בין השמשות וכו'. מכל מקום, אף כאן היה לו לעשות כן, כדי שלא יבואו לטעות שגם קודם לשמשות שפיר דמי. ושוב ראיתי למאמר, נגיד את המאמר מרדכי, שכן העיר תורי זהב, שמשמעות הלשון אין הכן, אין שם. וכן העיר בחוק יעקב, שהתז נדחק להוסיד דברי הפוסקים מפשעתם. וגם הנהר שלום, באמת, יא. כתב שהתז נדחק בזה, וראיתי להגירז בשולחן ערוך שלו סעיף י"ב שנרגש כסת בזה, ולכן פירש שתפילה היא בעוד יום סמוך לשקיעה. וכשמגיעים לספרת העומר כבר שקה החמה אין שם. וכן נראה מה שכתב הרב הגאון רבי דוד בן שלמה זכרו לברכה בספר שתילי זיתים. That's the big Yemenite rabbi as far as וכן פירש דברה בזית רענן, זית רענן. ואני יודע, אפילו גם זה דוח הגדול, למאחד העיקר הדין הוא ספירה, היה לו למרן לפרש מתי סופרים הם, ולא להטעותנו שנסבור דאף הספירה בעוד יום הייתה. מה כל כך חש, וכשאתה מרן מפלא מהעים הסיבור בעוד יום, היינו דאף סופרים הם בעוד יום. אחר כך ראיתי בתורתם של ראשונים, שהם בואה להדיע בדבריהם שהם בעוד יום, היינו כפשוטו ולא בין השמשות. נהנה בספר איסוף היטל ראשי, כתב ראשונו, בין פסח לעשרת, בסיבור ממהרים תפילת ערבית מבעוד יום. They're afraid of the crusades to be out at night, they want to get home.
Is that, yeah?
It's Rashi writing it.
Okay.
That's the crusade period of the year. You know, it's very possible. So they pray early to get home. Or it could be they're just late over there in their part of the world,
they're praying
early because it's too late to pray late, Misibur, to get out.
Right.
I mean, either way, I like to look at that other side of the crusade, just, you know, so we remember, you know, that we have to always put things into that historical perspective. Umonir bi im Misibur, yamim ushbod belo berakha, mimar amar, im izkor halayla bi beti ahzor ve abarech kedin. למשל שלא ברכתי ברכה לבטלה קודם שקיעה את החמה פירוש. ועל ידי שלא ברך כדאי קודם שקיעה, נמנע מאיסור ברכה לבטלה. אם אשכח, הרי מניתי עם משבועות המזווה, כן שלא. וכן עוד השבועות ראשי, סימן ש"ז בספר האורה, חלק ב', סימן ק"ב. ושבילי הלקס, סימן י"ו, אוקיי, והרי הדיע בספר יד גופיה הייתה קודם לשם שלו, וכן הביא הרשב"ד תשובה, חנה הביאו מגן אברהם, פרי חדש, בסדר. Very nice. ראיתי להרב מעתיק בספר שתי זיתים שהסכים עם פירוש שתי זיתים והוסיף דעת כן שינה מרן בשולחנו הטהור מלשון השאלה שנשאל הרשב"א ששם מבואה להדיא שספירה עצמה הייתה קודם שקד החמה והעתיק לשון אבו דרהם שיש מצוות אין שם זאת אומרת אין מזה רעד אם כדי להוסיענו בטעות היה לו למרן לכתוב בפירוש שהספירה הייתה אחר שקיעה בפרט שבית יוסף לא הביא מרן כלה לתשובת הרשב"א אם כן ודאי שהיה היה לו לשנות מלשון אבו דרהם כדי שיהיה מבואר שספירה לא הייתה בעוד יום. He keeps going, he has a lot to say on this. He's done his homework, you could tell. I'm telling you, this guy is powerful. He goes through every Rishon, every Aharon, he doesn't leave a stone unturned. This is all the same thing. All on this same little line of Shulchan Aruch. Did he finish? What was... So he had nothing to say on Seif Dalit? I wonder. No, I missed. No, here. It ended here. I didn't see it. But yeah, here, look. What do you have? 2 pages, 4 pages, 6 pages, 8 pages on this one seri. Yes. Whatever. But we got the basic idea of what's going on. He's able to prove what he's saying. He's not some slouch, you know, coming by with some weird pirush. It's something that's that makes sense, and he has sources for it, and it's based upon things that he went digging for, and he went, you know, and he proves both sides of the coin. Not to me, 100% this guy, you can tell. You know, and he's a young guy. The book came out in 2000. It's really a while that it's out. And they refer to Bahur, right? Bahur Hayakar.
Wow. Beautiful.
It really is beautiful. Shalom Mesas, also. And
he's still signed, yeah.
Ha'abrich. Okay? But Abrich, Bahirei Yeshivat Kisera Hamim. Harab Dekel Kohen Shalita. Look at this. Look at the beautiful thing. Rabbi Shalom Mesas doesn't just write anything like that. Sefer kullo medaber al dinei Sefirat HaOmer b'harifut u'b'kiut nifla'a. Ma'arich u'menateyach kol anyan. Ad shemagiyah l'asukeh shem'atata l'ibadah l'chata. Beautiful. Tadid le'a amek abate tadid. Ashrei shezei yalad. Ashrei yeshivat kisei rahamim shemagedid abrachim ke'ilu. Yishar chilei l'oraita l'a'il l'amikob l'chata. Oh, you dad, be a short show. Be a sheer, I bet you think a illu. Be a live, my little Torah. Be a year, the gaunt, be a beauty, and I was there. That's very powerful coming from him. Especially halakha, because he loves halakha, and he loves the ins and outs of it, you know? It's powerful. Very, very powerful. Anyway.
Anything from Harvard, yeah?
Rabbi Yaakov Yosef.
Oh, Rabbi Yaakov. Oh, really?
Uh-huh.
Oh, wow. Hazan Yaakov.
Do you have someone with Yosef? I think you had someone with Yosef in the beginning, no?
See it.
No. He didn't bother. He has his Rosh Hashiva. Yes. It'll be Shalom Mesas.
And
it'll be Yaakov Yosef. Can you have all the crew? Yeah, my name is Tarif, the Khonska the Head. We have the Mahabesh, he's created the Mother of the Asoy, Fusma and Tab Husa, Maturash, Bechter, Turash Baal Pi, I mean.
Simple man.
Simple. Yeah. Simple. But you know, you don't see it'll be Yaakov Yosef any place, you know?
I never saw his.
Nothing. Never knew he had to, you know. Anyway. Alright. Let's see, where are we now? So we finished this,
Right, this, He'ara.
אבל טוב ונכון שביהיה ספירה ישנו את מנהגם. ויאחלו התפילה. It's better that they change their custom and, you know, and make the תפילה later. כדי שפירו בשדות כוכבים, או לכל הפחות בין השמשות. So they can count at שדות כוכבים, or at the very least בין השמשות. ואפילו בערב שבת קודש, נכון שיעשו כן. אבל יחיד, שאינו רגיל פלל ערבי עם פלג המנחה, אף כשפלל עם הסיבור שגילים פלל ערבי עם פלג המנחה, ויסוף להם מיד אחר כך בברכה, אין רשע לספור עמם ברכה, אלא יספור בלו ברכה, בלא יחזור יספור בברכה. This is the way he feels about it. He explains himself. It's a little bit weak, but he still has, you know, ground, more ground than we have for, you know, to open our mouths.
Right, right.
Okay, the next halacha we don't need. I just want to see the next, the one after that. Halacha Yud Gimel. There's a word of Teshuvah about this subject also, and it was interesting to see. Tefillat Arbit. Kodemet lemezvat Sefirat HaOmer. Arbit has to come before the Omer. You can't say, oh, it's time for the Omer now, I'm going to count the Omer. No, you have to pray Arbit. Kevish Malim Ota Bechol Yom Mimot Hashanah, Tadir Shem Tadir, Tadir Kodim. Simple. ومنهج يروشلايم لسبور بسفرة عمر أحر علي نشبيح وبشات منهج زي بهربيكي هلوت
أفتر
نشبيح أفتر نشبيح and they can't afterwards אבל הנכון יותר, what's more correct, על פי הדין, לספור מיד אחר קדיש תקבל, like we do. More correct, if the קדיש תקבל, and he proves that תפילת ערבית meant, once you finished the עמידה back in the old days, that was the end of ערבית.
That's it, right.
Now we finished.
קדיש תקבל.
So now it's time to count the עומר. The other, the שיר המעלות, שיר המעלות is extra, the other שיר המעלות is extra. You cannot put the extra stuff now before the עומר.
The עומר, right.
Okay, מקום מקום.
Can I let you want to read that?
What? Yeah, we're going to come back and read it. Okay. Just read the... Oh, let's read it now. You're right. Okay. Go ahead. You read.
וכן העליתי בסטייתה דשמיה וחלק השוט, סימן ה' בשם בעוד פת בארנו. דעתם לזה הוא מאחר שספירה היא חיוב. בשביל המעלות וערים לשבח אינם חיוב, אלא רק ראוי ונכון לאומרם. לכן, אף על פי ששיר למעלות ועלינו לשבח תדירים יותר, right, you would say, תדיר ותדיר
כובן. No, there's more תדיר, but there's more, we have the חיוב on the עומר, which you don't have on these items.
מכל מקום נראה שאין להעדיף התדיר, אלא אם כן הוא חיוב. Right, so of course the חיוב is going to come before.
Right.
Something
that's true. חיוב.
אבל אם אין לו חיוב, לשנה להקדימו, משום תדיר, לא שנה?
לא שייך.
להקדימו משום תדיר בפרט. שיש להקדים את הספירה ככל שאפשר. Right. We should say the ספירה as early as possible, כמבואר לאל בסעיף ט' בהערה שלושים. וכן כתב הגאון רבנו זלמן משולחן ערוך שלו, סעיף הבא, במשנה ברורה, שיש לספור מיד אחר קדיש תתקבל, לפי שיש להקדים הספירה ככל שאפשר.
Fine.
Right, so as, right, to do it as soon as the night is set, right? והוספנו עוד שם, שכן מוכח ומבואר בכמה ראשונים ואחרונים, וכן כתב הרב המגיה לשלמי חגיגה, בשם סדר היום, שכן נהגו העולם, משום שכל הקהל בבית הכנסת, וברוב עם, הדרת מלך.
Right, because people might cut out.
Right, so people might the leave. Right.
After the, you know, everybody's waiting for Kaddish Kabbal after the Amidah. Everybody's
right,
still there.
Right. You know, and if they leave, they might miss Sefirah of you. וגם בנהר מצרים הנזכר לאל כתב, שכן מנהג עירם קהיר ועיר נעמון אלכסנדריה, ושהוא מנהג יפה. Right, so that was the מנהג in Egypt. וכן פסק מורנו רבנו ויתר את ראשנו, הגאון רבי
משה הלוי שליטה.
That's his teacher.
That's his teacher, right.
ושוט תפילה למשה. שם בעוד כתבנו שם ליישב טענת הכף החיים שנשנות מסדר התפילה וכן ישבנו מה שהעיר שאין כן פשט דברי מרן
I don't know who it's got to be somebody modern but I don't know who
okay
But, you know, usually, you know, the Mekubalim say, you know, you cannot change anything from the order of the prayers, you have to keep things in order.
Right.
You know,
right.
So that's where the Kaf Hayim falls in over here.
Right. Okay.
Right, I'm back on top. Mekum HaKom HaNogim L'Sfor HaHal HaNinu Shabbayah Yesh Lehem Anash Yismochu Bel Nechon Sheyishnu Min Hagam B'Derchei Noam.
Okay.
Even if, you know, they have a source to rely upon, let them change. If they can do it in a peaceful manner.
Right.
Anash HaNogim B'Kehilot HaMarokaim בישראל וחוסר על הספור בין ברכו לבין עלינו שבח נראה שאין לו טעם דיו. Okay, the Moroccans have a custom to do the sefirah between ברכו לעלינו שבח. They don't seem to have much of a reasoning behind it. ולכן יש להם לשנות מנהגם. They should change their custom. ועל כל פנים, בדי שאין זה מעכב כלל. Obviously.
Right, that's fine.
Right, but you see how it's not like you have to change and that's it. No.
Right.
But I'll call Penny, but any cave at Dash is a Makib Kedel. Okay?
Nice.
It is saying Pashut, she calls it like the Hadihla, whom he ought to. I'm going to call it Deer, Shad the Spool, Alpha Halit of Eleven, she calls it Lay, 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 Okay.
Right, of course.
Anything else I wanted to do from this? I forgot. Nah. I would have, if we had other people here, maybe I would do the, you know, the next one, Ted Vav, but. Not that important. Now let's look at some Perqe Abot. What do you say?
Okay, definitely.
Okay, let's give David another folder. Okay, now we're going to look at Perqe Abot. We're going to look at some Pirushim from Rabbenu David Hanagid, the grandson of Harambam, And we'll look at Pirush from Rabbi Yosef Nahmias, who was a rabbi in Toledo, Spain, early 1400s, and he was a good friend of Rabbi Huda, the son of the Rosh, and they were, of course, Talmidim of the Rosh. Well, a few different interesting Mishnayot in Perqe Abot, Perek Aleph. We have Mishnah here. Yosef ben Yohanan, Ish Yerushalayim Omer, יהי ביתך פתוח לברכה, ויהיו עניים בני ביתך, ואל תרבה שיחה עם האישה, ואשתו אמרו, קל וחומר באשת חברו, מכאן אמרו החכמים, קל הרבה שיחה עם האישה, גורם רעה לעצמו, ובוטה בנבי תורה, וסופו יורש גהן. A lot of things going on in this Mishnah.
Right.
And it's a Mishnah that obviously causes a lot of animosity from the side of women. You know, they don't like it, like what's going on over here. And obviously it's something that needs to be looked into, see how our earlier Hachamim viewed it and how they meshed it all together. Okay? Let's look at the... You know what? Who should we look at first? What do you say?
Okay,
all right, so look at B. David. Go ahead.
He says, Rabbi Yosef ben Yohanan, Ish Yerushalayim Omer, Asave otecha ben Adam, Tamid yehe betecha patuach lemaase ha-sedaka.
Hey, always let your house be always open to do charity.
V'chol mi sheyeser lo yikanez bo v'yasar yirvacha.
Anybody who just comes to him, he can come into your house and he can come out, you know, feeling full, feeling, you know, satiated from anything he needs. Beautiful, right? Let the widows, the orphans, let them come to your house and they be dear to you, like they're your own children. Okay, well, you're giving them, you're not giving them your own stuff, you're only giving them what God gave you.
Right.
I mean, these people, they're so broken, and they don't care about anything anymore. They've gone through a living nightmare. They don't care, you're angry, you blow up at them. They're always crying, no matter what. They don't change. Let, you know, hopefully God saves us from them and from their curse. In other words, we don't want to be like them. We don't want to be in their shoes.
Right.
So now somebody comes to you for tzedakah, okay, is yatom, is almana, you know, whatever it is, and you don't have what to give, you should make an effort and go get some other people and give to this, you know, yatom or almana. Therefore, you do a mizvah, and you are causing the others to be meritorious to be included in that mizvah as well. And if you cannot easily attain from other people, you have to try to, you know, to push them a little bit, speak to them, you know.
Make them feel that, right?
Exactly, make them feel like, you know, the plight of the, you know, of the downtrodden.
ויאמר להם, תסלחו לי, היה ברצוני שאתן לכם, אבל העין רואה והיד קצרה.
And if you still can't, you obviously tell these poor people, I'm sorry, I tried to get, I couldn't get, you know, and I really want to give, please, you know, forgive me. My eyes see your oppression, see what you need, but my arm is short, doesn't reach into deep enough into the pocket, because there's nothing in the pocket. The pocket itself is empty. Give them a berakha. Tell them that hopefully God will fulfill all your desires. He will give you from His own hand, from His outstretched arm, and you will not need any more to go and take out, you know, ask people for
tzedakah.
And obviously they're going to hear it if you're speaking it seriously from your heart. they're going to take it as such, and they will be consoled, you know, and they're going to feel a little bit better than they felt before.
Right.
Aval, it means zof. If you get all fired up and angry now, v'yomar lo, lech la'abod, go, get out of here, go work. Ho'i v'yeshlecha kitafayim she'efad esabir. Yeah, you have shoulders. You can go carry things. Okay?
Right.
We refer not just to the walnut, but I guess to the wood of the trees itself. Look at yourself. You have eyes. Open your big eyes and look. Look how big you are. Look how tall. Look how wide. Aren't you embarrassed? You
have
to go around, you know, and ask for
tzedakah.
Okay, what you did in the book over here, doing the right thing, you embarrassed him. You spilled his blood. It's like you killed him.
Right,
not only did you give him anything, but you were jealous on his eyes and on his health and on his body, and this is a hate to be jealous.
And
not only that, you also now you don't have hate on Habba.
Right.
Why? Because you embarrassed this Ani and you spilled his blood in front of other people and you embarrassed him publicly.
Right.
You give them quietly on the side, they come, they go, nobody knows anything. Right, let's say he was from a good family, they had money, but whatever, you know, tables turned on him, and now he doesn't have what he used to have before, he really needs it. And he, because he was in such a position, of course he would feel even more embarrassed to go out asking and for people to see.
Yoter.
It has to be, you know, very, very much on the hush-hush, on the QT.
Right. That's beautiful. Yeah, that's very nicely read.
So, yeah, it's clear, not only is he explaining Perqe Abot, he is explaining the Pesukim of Tehillim now.
That was very nice, that Pesuk, the way
that.
ועל זאת חובה לאדם ליתן צדקה בסתר לאיזה אני שיהיה.
Okay, person's obligation to give צדקה בסתר.
Right, לפי שמראה, מי שהוא שנותן צדקה בגלוי, ישבחוהו בני אדם ויאמרו פלוני בעל צדקה.
They see him giving, oh, look at this guy, ho-ho, he's a big philanthropist.
Right, ותישאר המזווה בלתי שלמה.
So now the מזווה will not be complete. Especially all the more so they start, you know, giving him honor and respect because they know he gives money. Right? He's
going
to lose out on this zechut and on this mizvah, this attack in this world because of what's going on in this world that they're giving him all this kavod.
Right.
See how he goes to the next part of the Mishnah?
Yeah.
He goes right into the next part of the Mishnah. We're talking about, you know, giving tzedakah, you know, patuach. So now he goes right into it. Now if it happens to be, right? Now, if it happens to be one of the people, one of these poor people that are asking for tzedakah happens to be a woman.
Not a bit of barim hima.
Do not, you know, overly indulge in chatter with her.
Right. Lefi shirabu yad debarim im ahanashim yafilu shetihiya ishto goreret leadam lachato ve'esver.
Be'asuk. Because increase of talk with women, even if it's your own wife, causes a man to sin, and it's forbidden.
Right.
And what, all the more so, you know, somebody else's wife.
Right. בעניין המאמר הזה לימדנו חזר שכל המרבה דברים עם האנשים גורם רע לעצמו בהוצאת
שכבד זירה ובטלה
בפריסות והחסנות.
מזנות, okay? So what happens over here? Anybody who increases speech with women, he causes evil to befall himself through what? Through the spilling of semen and perisut and zenut. And now all this obviously causes what? Bitul Torah. You're so involved with this stuff, you're not studying Torah. In the end, what happens to you? You keep falling deeper and deeper down, till you fall down into the pit of Gehenna.
אמרו חזר שכל מי שיקח דבר מיד אישה שתהיה
אשת
איש כדי להסתכל ביופייה, לא ינקה מייסורי גהינם.
אלה החמים, כן, מסכת ברכות, that anybody who takes something from a woman's hands and she's, you know, and she's אשת איש, so he takes from her so he can look at her beauty, he will not easily be forgiven, you know, or...
Not come out clean.
Not come out, okay, from, you know, from the sorrows and the troubles of Gehinnom. Kemamar ketub.
Ketub yad liyad lo inakera.
Right, the Mishle.
Ve'od amar lo inake kol hanoge ba ve'afilu be'etzva'a.
Ketana.
Kepe
lan Hashem. In other words, God, please, you know, for you save us from this type of situation.
אשר על כן מזמן לאדם אישה ענייה והיא אשת איש, ידע כסף תיתן לה צדקה בדרך שלא יפנה אליה.
It happens to be, you have to do it in a way that you don't start having direct dealings with her.
רק ייתן לה על ידי אחרים כדי שלא יבוא לידי חטא, ונמצא יורש גהינום, כמו שאמרו בסופו יורש גהינום. Very nice.
Very nice. It's not? Yeah.
Oh, he really read the Mishnah beautifully.
He read the Mishnah very nicely.
Right.
Simple. To the point, and he made it flow. He's not showing, he's showing that the Mishnah is not a bunch of obscure points, but it's all tied into each other, and the Lashon of the Hachim in the Mishnah is, you know, like footnotes, like an outline, and you have to know that this outline is connected one to the other to the other.
Right.
That's the way he's looking at it. Now let's look at how Rabbi Yosef bin Nahmias from Spain looks at the same Mishnah. Go ahead, since you were reading.
Right, so he says,
Yosef ben Yohanan.
Yosef ben Yohanan, Yehi betekha batuach levacha, Shima se'usham, Kol over v'shav,
Levacha,
Echama gadol achnasat orchim,
Se'ul man, Amraham abinu ala v'shalom,
Shalom shenata eshev b'ber sheva, V'hiyuan, Shenata v'eshev b'ber sheva, Right, so he stops there.
Right, he says, how much so he has to be open? You know, because it's very great people to come and go from your house, and you know, we should learn the greatness of Hakhnasat Arhim. I'm going to learn from Abraham Abinu, who you say he planted a tree in Be'er Sheva. Right. You'll be, you know, you should be so much involved in giving charity, you know, that the aniyim should be come and go from your house, as if they were your own, you know, family members coming and going on a regular basis.
דבר אחר, במקום שתקנה עבדים ושפחות לשמשך, תשמש בעניים.
תפרנס אותם, תקבל עליהם שכר. It's a nice way of looking at it. You're going to hire people to work for you in your house anyway. Hire the poor people. That way, at least, they can earn their keep. You know, and you get the sechar. Not only are you paying them and helping them, but you're also getting sechar of the mizvah because you're helping them.
Right.
You know, you're giving them tzedakah, but tzedakah with dignity. You know, because they're actually doing the job.
Right. So now he goes into the next one. Ve'altarvesi hay mahisha, shelo sichat anashim,
mitashmisha mitta.
Ah, v'chen b'masechet derech es. התרבי חי מהאישה שכל שיחתה של אישה
מדברי נעופים.
נעופים.
ואשתו אמרו שכן דה שום שחייה.
תגיד יד המסיחו. אפילו
שהיא קלה שבינו לבין עצמו.
שיחה קלה. ראית, שיחה קלה שבינו לבין עצמו. עתיד ליתן
עליה את הדין.
בתקנות
לבינה לבעלי
כדי שלא יהיה מסוי איש עשר אשתו כתרנגול. וכן פירשתי בפסוק.
I guess the תרנגול is always
must be.
Must be,
right.
לכן פירה של פסוק.
פסוק קהלת.
חיים המשה שאהבת.
אף על פי שאתה אוהב אותה, מאחר בחיים
על אהבתיך, ותיתן אנשים חיליך.
ופירשתי ראי חיים מלשון נראים דברי
אדמון.
אדמון.
אני יודע?
על פי שאתה אוהב אותה, בחג החיים על אהבתך ותיתן אנשים חיליך. So I guess don't be with her all the time, even though you love her.
It's a quote from Ketubot, and the Gerasha is over there. Says, "Ro'e ani et debre admon." Now that makes a difference. Okay.
Quite a data machine. He flew the Rambam, the Sefer Hamada, the Haluim, Habayim, the Tashmish.
Well, no, in Sefer Madar, Rambam talks about, you know, the types of illnesses that befall you from, you know, due to overly having sexual relations.
קל וחומר ואשת חברו, האסורה לו, שגובר עליו יסרו, ומה מגנובים אם תעקו. אוקיי, סויד. ובאבות דריבי נתן, באשתו נידה אמרו, also, this, over there, there's an extra word of נידה.
Right.
אם באשתו נידה שיש לו היתר, לפי שעה חששו להרגל, עבירה,
קל וחומר ואשת חברו. בגרסתנו, אין הוא גורס נדע, וכאשר ביארתי מכאן, אמר האחרים כולם בשיחה עם האישה, גורם רע לעצמו, שמגבר עליו ישרו, ובוטה מדברי תורה, בעוד שמרבה עמה שיחה בתהילה, וסופו יורש גהנם, שסופו הבא לידי עבירה, וטוב לפני האלוהים, ימלט במן... He's trying in Kohelet a lot over here.
Yeah.
He's trying in three pesukim from Kohelet.
But the truth,
totally different.
The flow that he had over here was
actually totally different. But it's still interesting to see. I mean, you know, different mishnayot, you get different, you know, insight also. See, the problem is we don't have Rabbi Yosef Mesas on these early perakim.
Right.
And then even when we have the later perakim, each mishnah has pages.
Yeah, okay. I gotta look at where does it start? What do we have? What do you have?
Earlier, I have Problem is, you can't figure out. He doesn't tell you clearly what he's up to.
Right.